Today, in our third part of our situational pruning, for third segment, we're going to use an older established hybrid vine trained to a high wire system. And you can see, if you look closely, the established cordons, the semi-permanent wood that runs horizontally along that fruiting wire. We also will notice that this vine is not grafted. If you look at the bottom, so down at the base of the vine, we can see that it's been cut off at some point and is regrowing. So prior to that, it regrew two pretty nice trunks, and we're going to use those and just spur these remaining trunks and cut those out of the way. We did spur one that has a couple buds on it in case we need a third trunk, but the rest of them we're going to cut and get out of the way. I like to make a lot of little cuts again. I don't like to pull on the brush too much unless I'm in a big hurry, because I tend to get slapped in the face. This is a hybrid vine and does not require grafting per se. Sometimes grafting is called for, but with these hybrid vines, it's not a bad way to go and let them grow on their own roots. Okay, I'm going to work my way up. Once we get up here to the cordons, it's a pretty straightforward process. What we want to do is have what we call short canes or long spurs, and we're going to cut each of these fruiting wood sections or canes to about 5 to 6 buds. Those buds will grow and drape procumbently, and then once they drape down, the fruit will be at the top part of the vine as it's trained here. A cane is something more than about 5 buds long, and a spur is typically 2 to 3 buds long. So these can be called short canes or long spurs, whatever you prefer. If I run across a spur position that seems pretty weak, I'm going to cut it back pretty severely and maybe even cut it all the way back, and hopefully a latent bud at the base of that spur position will pop and grow next season and create a new position. So we're just working along, cutting long spurs or short canes. An ideal cane would be something like this, that is about a number 2 pencil in diameter and has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fruiting buds on it. So this is nice right there. This is another good one. So this vine's in pretty good shape, actually. Just work your way along there. Now, if you run across a cane like this one and you say, what are these other smaller canes coming off of it? These are actually laterals that were formed and grew in a single season. So in 2020, the summer thereof, they were formed and grew out in 2020. Most of the time they are not fruitful, but sometimes they are, and I'm going to spur them back as well. But remember, the main fruiting structure is that 1-year-old cane, not these laterals. Just kind of cleaning it up as we go. You know, grapevines are kind of like people. You have to approach them as individuals, even though you do want them to be productive. You got to let them work with you, whatever they present you. This is an interesting formation. This was a spur position that has given us three choices here. Let's go ahead and cut that one all the way off. It's pretty small in diameter compared to these other two. And we're going to count our 5 buds and use that as our fruiting position. Again, this is a small one, but I like the position. I'm just going to use about 1 bud there. Take off the old dead wood. This is a completely dead spur. We're going to remove it. Sometimes I like to take the tendrils off as well. They can be pretty vigorous and actually choke off some of the new wood. So be sure and remove those if they seem like they'll be problematic. So there we go. This is a hybrid vine, own rooted, trained to a high wire system, and prune to this long spur short cane system that likes to hang down. So we would really, we'd prefer all the cane positions or the spur positions to come off the top 180 degrees of that cordon. So these are preferred more so than something like this coming off the bottom, but I'm keeping it simply because there's a big gap here and we need some fruiting wood there. So there you go. You might want to leave a few buds in the middle of the vine, and those can be called replacement spurs in case this cane or cordon goes south or gets killed for some reason. You'll have a replacement piece of wood to lay down and replace it with.